Vancouver West End.
Thank you all. A year and a half ago, when the Premier was courting gay and lesbian British Columbians for her leadership bid, she promised to make tackling homophobic bullying one of her top priorities. Since then, we've had talk in the throne speech and more promises in this session. When I last raised this issue, the Premier said, quote, "There are very few issues about which I am more passionate than this one," and promised to work with me to, quote, "bring in the best legislation, the best policy, the best methods we possibly can for addressing this issue." Can the Premier explain why, with 2 days left in this session, she still has not done anything to address the fact that almost three-quarters of BC schools don't have strong, explicit policies to protect youth from homophobic bullying?
Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The member should stay tuned. He'll see it very soon.
Member of the Supplemental.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. When I told the House the story of David, a grade 9 student who attempted suicide because he was being constantly bullied at school for being gay, the Premier said, quote, "We will be taking action on this, as I promised, in this, our second session of the legislature." Yet with 2 days left to the end of this sitting, there has been no action. When David was asked if he expected the Premier to keep her promise, he said, quote, "She's a politician. You can't really expect that much. They say they're going to do something, and they don't." Can the Premier explain to David and lesbian, gay, and transgender students across BC why she has broken her promise to them this session?
Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. You know, I think one of the things that is important for us in politics is to recognize where good work has happened. And I know that the member in the past has been complimentary or at least acknowledged the work that I've done on this issue in the past. I have to say, over the last 5 or 6 years of my life, there's no issue to which I have devoted more passion and more concern than the issue of bullying for kids, bullying of individuals, whether they're in schools, whether they're in workplaces, or whether that happens at home or in other places in our society. Bullying is something that scars people for life. And we need to do a couple of things. First of all, we need to change the way we deal with bullies and recognize that in a bullying situation, it's not like some typical disagreement you might find between two people. One is a victim and one is a perpetrator, and they need to be dealt with appropriately. So that's one element of the plan that the member will see very shortly. Second, we have to make sure that we are encouraging people to stand up against bullies. If there is one thing we can all do to make a difference, it's to remind each other and ourselves that when we see bullying happen around us, we stand up. Because when we stand up and when we step in and protect those who are vulnerable and being bullied, we deprive the bully of oxygen. That's ultimately the way that we're going to be able to change bullying. It's a change in culture, and it's something that I think is achievable for British Columbia. Will it be achievable in a month or 2 months or a year? No. But we're going to get started, and as I said to the member, we're going to get started very soon.